G'day, Gary from Travel Outback Australia here. Today I thought I'd give you a bit of an update on how the camper trailer build is going. I've designed this trailer myself based on an idea I got from an American company. It's made out of 4x2 RHS or 100x50 in metric. It's got a swing away spare wheel carrier, external guards, and as you can see down here, it's got Cruise Master suspension. The Cruise Master suspension is optioned up to hopefully go with the weight expectations of the overall trailer once it's built. As you can see, I've started putting in some wiring funneled up along the inside of the tube. That idea hasn't worked particularly all that well as I've been building the trailer, because I found out up the front that when I got the chassis welded up, the holes here were a little bit unexpected. I did expect the cable to route up all the way to the front here, and so I've had to put extra holes in, which means back here I'm going to end up with a little junction box where I'll join up the wiring that's going from one side of the trailer down each side. So that's going to be a little bit messy, but hopefully by the time I clean it all up, it'll work out well. I've got a Cruise Master DO35 version 3 coupling up the front here, and that's got the handbrake attachment on it, and I've also set up the brakes now, and you can see the cable is running back down along each side back to the brake drums. You'll see along each edge, like at these points here, I've got these little tabs, and that's going to be where the floor will bolt onto the trailer chassis. On each side, I've got a couple of grab handles which will help maneuver the trailer around. Also at the front as well, an ARC Corporation jockey wheel rated to the expected weight of the trailer as well. The next step in finishing this particular stage is to get the wiring done, and then to order in the sheets of ply, which will ultimately become the side frames of this particular trailer. I'm going to line the insides of the mud guards because on the top side I expect to put aluminium checker plate, and that's not going to cater all that well to stones bounding up inside the mud guards. And so up underneath here, I'm going to line this with some steel plate, thin steel plate, just to take the hammering I expect it's going to get. In the rear here, you can see these tabs here. And also underneath here, that's going to hold the water tank. I've got a 85 litre stainless steel water tank that's going to sit under this particular section. And that will ultimately be piped up to a sink that's going to sit in the rear hatch area here. I'm really hoping that the frame design is going to come off. I made a couple little changes as I went along, including these braces at the rear of the suspension where the shock absorbers hang off. But also up the front here where the swing arm hangs off. So I'm hoping that's going to take, again, the sort of hammering that we at Travel Outback Australia put some of our equipment through from time to time. Not intentionally, but we like to go off-road quite a bit. And, it can be rough out there. And we want this trailer to be able to withstand it. On the front section here, right across this section here, I expect to put a checker plate box, and I'm going to steal a few ideas from various great designs that I've seen around the place. And in this particular box, I'm going to have on one side room for the gas cylinders, and then on the other side that will have the power system in it. I'm going to have an accessory box, and that's going to have our battery management system in here, and Red Arc have supplied the Battery Manager 30 system, which will help me ticking away when we're out in the bush on remote trips that sometimes last for quite long periods of time. At the rear of the camper, in under the hatch, I'm going to have a series of drawers and pull-out kitchen arrangements. For the various aspects around the trailer, like the sides, the access doors, the little PA doors that will be on the side of this hybrid teardrop, Dunn and Watson are going to be supplying those doors. At the rear, I'm hoping to also get them to help out by making some custom drawers, which will incorporate the kitchen. So that will include a pull-out arrangement for the fridge, but also a sink and a cooker type drawer system, which we'll pull out from the rear of the trailer here. I decided to fit CSA alloy wheels, and I quite like the design, so I've fitted those to the trailer. Now back down to this front section from this side, I expect that the upper section, it's going to come up about 700 odd millimetres. And that will actually, on the top section, it will be separated from the bottom, but that will house a little baby Q Weber, which will swing out when we pull up for use. The whole idea with this trailer is to make everything as minimal effort as possible, so that when we do pull up, we can actually be pulled up, have our chairs out, and be sitting down relaxing by the campfire as quickly as possible. And then with all these little add-on bits like the barbecue, the sink and the stuff at the back of the trailer, we hope that's going to make our life easier, and it's going to be easy to pack away. And well, I guess we'll see when the trailer's finished. But that's about where we're up to at this stage. And I'm a little bit anxious about the next stage, I'm going to have to go and live by that whole measure twice, cut once. In my case, it's probably going to be measure half a dozen times and hopefully cut once. So we'll see where it takes us from there. Okay, thanks a lot for watching. And at the next stage, this is not going to be a how-to series. This is going to be just a progress type video series. And hopefully you'll join me on this journey as we build the trailer up from this point here. If you want to get on board and help me out with this build for Travel Outback Australia, then give us a yell through our website contact page. Thanks for watching, and hopefully we'll catch up to you again sometime in the future.